Thank you very much. So, yeah, as Laura said, this is a new thing that I've been doing. I was very lucky during lockdown to find out that after sort of maybe 25, 30 years of since I first heard the Gnawa music from Morocco, and slowly I started to learn a bit more about it. And you know, I've even been out to Morocco and played with some great master there. I suddenly found out that during COVID, there was a master of the tradition living who had just moved to Bristol during COVID. So as soon as we were allowed to, we got him over. And so this is a new thing and a great pleasure and an honour for me to be here with Mohamed Eraba. So I'd like to introduce you now to Driss Yamda. Who's gonna and Dave Smith on drums, who's an old pal of mine. You might local boy, and so we played together for many years with Jewel de Camera, and then later with Robert Plant. So it's good to be here. And, you know, since the lockdown, I've got to say, we're just enjoying playing more than ever, you know, because we know what it's like to not play for a while. So, yeah. Okay.
Tortellina,
Whoa!
Thank you, Dan.
Okay, just adjusting my tuning here. So, the next song, I've been reading, finally I got around to reading Homer's Odyssey. And it's an incredible book, but basically, for those of you that haven't read it, what, you know, you probably know the story. Basically, this guy gets kind of against his will because of some crazy story about, you know, effectively about sort of jealousy and you know, rape of a kind, I suppose. This guy gets forced into a war, which turns him into a sort of brutal killing machine. And then the journey he gets for 20 years after the war, he gets pushed around the Mediterranean by forces beyond his control. So forces of war, of famine, there's, you know, jealousy, and all these kind of terrible things that beyond his control. And it just kind of struck me as quite a realistic depiction of the world, really. And sure, yeah, it uses some kind of mythical concepts of kind of giants and this kind of thing, but it's actually, in a way, it's exactly what's going on now. So so this is the this is a song kind of about that, really. Thank you.
di bia khuya fin khadi bia fin khadi 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 bia khuya fin khadi bia
Thank you so much. That's that little bit of Arabic singing that we were doing there is from a group, a fantastic Moroccan group who's a huge inspiration to me as well. They're sort of massive figures in Moroccan music called Nasser Rouan. And so it's really worth checking them out. They don't seem to be very well known over here, but they were like a kind of... in a way, they're comparable to Bob Marley and the Wailers or something like that. You know, there's somebody who really, like, if you meet any Moroccan person, they can quote all their songs. You know, they had a huge impact, and they're quite politically engaged band. And the lyrics that we were singing there is like, "Where are you taking me, my brother?" And it's kind of understood amongst Moroccan people. Like, it's obvious what they're talking about. It's talking about people kind of getting arrested by secret police or police for you know, like the sort of crushing hand of the state, you know. So I kind of felt it worked along with the other lyrics. Anyway, so... here's another song from the fantastic repertoire of Gnawa traditional music, of which Mohammed and Driss are like walking encyclopedias of this incredible, great ancient culture. Thank you. Okay, well, special is an overused word. Already, I may have claimed that tonight was a special night, just us being together. But it's ultra special in that I've been coming over to Norwich a few times in the past month or so to meet up with these young people through Gary Newland and Laura, who's been an amazing team and getting us on you come, guys. I want to welcome these young people that I've been working with. Shout and shimmy. Okay. Okay. Here we go. Thank you very much. Shukran. Barak Laufik. So.
Shukran.
Abdu. Talyana. So, that last song was a song I believe originated in Tunisia, but it's known all over the Maghreb and the Middle East as well. And so we thought it was a fitting song to do, and it's an invocation of a saint, you know. So it's a good bringing the good vibes, you know. When I met with this guy Abdu, he brought a song to me that I'd never heard before, that comes from his homeland of Sudan, and so we've done our best to make a little arrangement of it, and so it's called Nukta Daw. And this is Abdu who's going to sing it for you. So, okay. Okay, so, ladies and gentlemen, that's our first half. We're going to be back with the same sort of shape again, so we're going to play about half an hour with the band, and then the guests are going to be back, and we are going to tear the roof off the proverbial. Okay, so see you soon. Okay. So, hello again and welcome to the second half. I thought I'd ask Mohammed to maybe introduce a little bit the next song. Most of the songs that Mohammed is singing, as we said, are from this incredibly rich tradition of Gnawa music, which is a form of a Sufi music that originated in West Africa, and it was West Africans who were brought to Morocco originally as slaves, who developed their own culture and their own music. So they've got hundreds of songs. It's often used, the music is often used for healing rituals, but as well for, you know, for other things as well. So, maybe you could talk about this next song, which is actually from a different tradition. Morocco is very rich in these Sufi brotherhoods with musical traditions, and so.
Yeah, good evening, everybody. So, like Justin said, Gnawa is old music, which is came from the West Africa. So the slave traders, they brought some slaves, and actually this, the crack of that was like the shackles, and the rhythm is like the steps of the slaves during that journey. And yeah, it's really old. It's like more than 8 centuries, and the instrument as well is old. And we use this music for the healing through the like nights or ceremonies. And this instrument, I want to just say about the instrument, is made from this camel skin. This is this part of the camel. Sorry if somebody vegetarian here or something. And the strings are from the intestines of the goat. So it's vegetarian, not vegetarian, 100%, I said. Yeah, so this next song, it calls Hamdushia, and we brought it actually from Hamadsha, is another Sufi tribe in Morocco, and we're playing it now in the order of Gnawa songs. So I wanna play it out for you guys. Thank you.
This next song is one of my favorite Gnawa tunes.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Well, I know you've been wanting to see those wonderful guests again. Ladies and gentlemen, now is your time. Bring them on, guys. Bring them on.
You won't know this, but we six percussionists have been having a little party side stage. There has been a lot of clapping, shaking, jiving, footwork. It's all been going on. It's fantastic. I don't know about you, but I'm having a great night, and I think they are too. So let me introduce you to our percussionists. So we have Mohammed. Mohammed attends Notre Dame High School. He is from Syria and he is self-taught playing the darbuka. Wow. Next to him we have Abdu. Obviously our star vocalist tonight. Abdu is from Sudan, and he's really keen to share with us the rich culture and tradition of Sudanese singing. So, Abdu, thank you for bringing us your culture. Next to Abdu, we have Abdu. Abdu attends City College and is from Nigeria. Abdu is exploring his musical repertoire. He has fantastic rhythm and is hoping to start learning the guitar soon as well. And last but definitely not least, we have Irada. Irada attends a primary school in Norwich. Well done, Irada, for joining us. It's a big order. And she loves Adele. Okay. Our percussionist.
Ladies and gentlemen, Laura Abro, who's been a fantastic host and is also pretty hot on the percussion over there as well. So multi-talented. Okay, so let me just get myself set for the next little groove. There we go. So you're there. And you're there. Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, I was incredibly lucky about 15 years ago to be invited by the British Council to go to Syria to do a collaborative project with some really good Syrian musicians. And I had such a great time there. I can't tell you, the people were so warm and kind. The level of musicianship was out of this world, you know, these really sophisticated and excellent musicians, very funny, very humble people. We got the hospitality we got was incredible, and then we played a few shows in Damascus, and then and it was everybody was dancing around playing the dabke, and then we went to Aleppo and played beautiful concerts. So you know, it was such a great thing to, you know, just see what a fantastic country and a fantastic culture and the warmth and intelligence of the people. Just, you know, I loved it. And so it's been really lovely to meet Mohammed here, who's you know, brought a lot of that back to me and brought those great memories back to me. And I love playing the music, and there's this particularly rhythm and a dance called dabke, which I really love to hear. And and Mohammed there likes to play dabke as well, so we've made a kind of dabke mashup with a bit of Anglo folk, Anglo-American folk music in there as well. So, I hope you like it. I think you will. And it's not for the faint-hearted. We're going to go all the way, guys. So, you know, come on. We'll be right back.
Fantastic playing. Woo. So, ladies and gentlemen, that's us. So, thank you very much indeed. Well, if you insist. Yeah, okay. We you know, we were halfway home, but you know, we thought. No, the truth is, we're desperate to play the next few songs. So. You know, it's showbiz, guys. Thank you.
by the river, I lay down. Down by the water, down on the ground, stars were above me, all shining bright. Deep river rolling all through the night. She's all right, she's all right.
right through the blinds. Tell you won't know what I'm gonna do. Gonna build a house right next to you. Hey, Mona, hey. We'll be right back.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you so much. Mohammed. Abdu. Brief. Dave Smith. Gary Newland, who organized this whole thing, who's been working on it for months. Ladies and gentlemen, a very, very big hand for Gary Newland. What an amazing job. Ladies and gentlemen, let through Laura Abro, please. The incredible. Irada, our youngest and coolest member of the band. From myself, Justin Adams, thank you very, very, very much. What a great night. And also, I want to thank so much Rob, who's been an amazing part of the team, the technical guy who's held it all together. And today, Joe, the sound guy. So thank you so much. And, you know, it's been great.
Just thank you so much for supporting this. This is, I think Justin and I go back about 20 years now, but this is the last concert of six incredible, enriching experiences with artists from around the world. It's something we hope to do once a year. So about this time, remember the name Connecting Cultures. If you see it about, you know it's just going to be full of amazing stuff. But I would like to thank all the schools that participated, four primary schools, secondary school, and our amazing team here. And special thanks to Krista Ribbons, if she's there. Is she? No, gone home. She's been inspirational. She's part of the Norfolk Music Hub. And through her, we've been able to really work and pick out the best teachers who can really motivate all the children. And it's just been all about cultural diversity and how enriching an experience that can be. So I'll leave you on that word, cultural diversity.